Alex Smith. Great to be on the broadcast today. A great little initiative from Toowoomba AFC. It's great to have the acknowledgement of the country that acquired to the game. So we're all looking forward to this. It's the juggernaut, it's the Tigers up against the new challengers in South Toowoomba. Thanks, Mitch. Great to be on the broadcast today. A great little initiative from Toowoomba AFC. It's great to have the acknowledgement of the country that acquired to the game.
It's a great
way to look forward to this. The juggernaut that's the Tigers up against the new challengers in South Toowoomba. Let's have a look at some technical. Thanks, Mitch. Great to be on the broadcast today. A great little initiative from Toowoomba AFC. It's great to have the acknowledgement of the country that acquired to the game.
It's a great way to look forward to this.
The juggernaut that's the Tigers up against the new challenges in South Toowoomba. Let's have a look at some technical. Thanks, Mitch. Great to be on the broadcast today. A great little initiative from Toowoomba AFC. It's great to have the acknowledgement of the country that acquired to the game.
It's a great way to look forward to this.
The juggernaut that's the Tigers up against the new challenges in South Toowoomba. Let's have a look at the technical. We're leaving just to get a dispute at the moment. Thanks, Mitch. Great to be on the broadcast today. A great little initiative from Toowoomba AFC. It's great to have the inside forward.
Watson. So ground level now. Grundon's there for South Toowoomba. Just gets it out towards. It's going to be well cut off. It's going to be a little bit of stop-start football. So Bianca Ross now with the footy. It's going to kick from about 48. Just going to go short, lowers the eyes. Right idea, poor execution. It's about 25 out now in front of goal. Bombers are going to be first to it. Crothers just gets a kick out. Nice tackle applied there by the Tigers. Now the Bombers are on the outer side here at Rockville Park, Tor Street. Nice little handball out. It's going to step back on the inside. Nice little move there by Pogany, the reigning best and fairest medalist. Stanmore takes a nice little chest mark on the inside. So Stanmore for South Toowoomba. Just eyes darting around. There's a few darting around, I should say. Can't quite take the grab. Just lands in between. Do apologise for any pronunciations of names that might be incorrect. Football comes. Well, it's just going to be wrapped up in that tackle. So the umpire says, I'll have it, please. As a nice little hit out in the ruck there. Clearing kick from the stoppage. Nice little grab at ground level was Baker of the Tigers. Walters has it at the moment. And we're going to have a repeat stoppage. To kickstart things, it's the early stages of this first quarter, Mitch.
Yeah, it's been hot footy. Plenty of footy down Tigers end at the moment as Curtis Stanmore takes a clearance there for the south side. Few conversions under there. Collins with a footy, but it looks like, well, just a little pull off the ground there. It gets a little bit of space for the Tigers as they release, but straight back to South Toowoomba as the ball spills about a little bit. There's a bit of bump there, a bit of physicality. Great tackling pressure at the moment from the Tigers. They're just sitting and swarming the South Toowoomba girls, and there's a fair bit of pressure at the moment as that ball looks to be wrapped up. No, umpire Thomas says play on. That one surely won't be getting out now. And well, the ball keeps rolling, and there's ball out now. That's through Baker, kicks it forward, and the ball's out on the half-forward flank. Looks like Hunt there, the new recruit from Townsville, softening the ball forward, trying to keep a bit of momentum going forward for the Tigers girls. Grundon there, little kick off the ground. Umpire Thomas has just picked up a little bit of a free kick there, and the ball will be south on the footy deep in their back half.
So Newman with the footy. Not too many options ahead. A few do present. It's going to be a one-on-one, so it's going to be 50-50. Going to set it up long. Bombers first at it through Sanchez, puts it on the left boot, but it's going to be cut off by Meskin's going to play on straight away. He's going to send it inside forward 50, straight through the legs of the Bombers player there, as Collins is going to bring it out to the broadcast side of Rockville Park, out in the front of Pogany. We're in the number 9. Crothers just snaps through 2, just says to the young stars, this is how you do it. It's going up towards the right half forward flank for South Toowoomba. Their first inside 50, it's going to be a shallow one. Bit of body in there applied by McKeever, but now with the football... is the Tigers, and they're going to get a scrappy looking kick. Crothers, nice tackle by Fraser. It's going to be rewarded. Good work by the young star. So Tigers now off the half back, Mitch.
Yeah, Fraser's been super impressive this year. Definitely one of the Tigers' outstanding players, and one of the youngest on the field as well. She unfortunately just turns the ball straight over to Sanchez, but the ball's in dispute there. Sanchez looks like she's going to go mop up her own mistake and just gets it across to Moody there, right in the centre of the ground. And Moody, a bit slow here, not a lot of options, so just tries to pump it long. Footy's now bouncing around there. Looks like Bree Tolles taking the footy. Gets it over to McKeever, one of the leading goal kickers at South Toowoomba this year. But still not a lot of forward pressure from the South girls here. The ball has just come out way too easy there, and they just haven't quite looked a threat yet, as the Tigers look like they'll be able to rebound here.
So 50-50 in dispute. Tigers able to get a boot in there. It's going to send it up to the outer side. First to the footy. It's a nice little contest between Jericho and I think that was Lamb out there. And the boundary's going to beat everyone. So we've got a boundary throw in. Centre wing, Tall Street side of Rockville Park. It's a beautiful winter's day now, we can say, Mitch, here in the Garden City.
It is. It's beautiful. There's no real breeze at the moment to speak of. It's a beautiful afternoon. Hopefully it will. We just went through a few technical difficulties. We may be a black screen here. It might be a radio call here, Jeff.
Really describe it, Mitch. Really describe it, mate.
Well, that's kind of just throws the ball straight into the foot there. Raking the right foot, actually, as the ball bounces to the ground. It looks like Freganese is dumped in a big tackle there, but the ball spilled out. And Baker fighting on the ground. Ball not really going anywhere. Freganese tries to clean up her own work and eventually just wrestles the ball out of there. As Sanchez pumps it forward to the forward flank, almost for the centre wing, realistically. I've given that a bit too much credit. And Pogany picks the ball up now. The reigning Heather Green medalist picks it forward in search of McKeever. A little bit lost there, might have just been hung up in the sun as the ball's just scrapping again, bouncing around on the ground. And, well, again, it looks like the Tigers just repel that forward 50 attempt at by the South girls. And Tigers seem to have all the answers at the moment.
Yeah, McEwen's been good off the halfback as it's now centre wing. First to the footies, Whitley of the Bombers, tackled very strongly there, right on the paint out on the far wing. So Tigers now with the footy, looking to go into attack. Might just slow things down. I thought they might have tried to be a little bit quicker there from Chloe Hunt. So Hunt now is going to go long along the lines, looking for a target in Jericho was the intended. Now at ground level, just try to dish up the handball off the ground there was Pretoris. And the boundary, once again, is going to beat everyone. It's 1-0 at the moment. Low-scoring start to this first quarter. Sir Doug Nicholls round.
It's tight stuff. I think the Tigers have got the upper edge at the moment, but just seem to have all the answers that South Toowoomba, just the questions that South Toowoomba are asking. But no one's really taken a stamp on the game. Certainly played between the 250-metre arcs at the moment as that ball's pumped up to centre wing on the far side of Rockville Park, where the ball has spent, probably a good 90% of his first term, Jeff.
Yeah, it is. It's stuck out there at the moment as players are just going at the footy. It's just sort of pinballing around. First of the footy is the Tigers. Just breaks through a couple. Nice work there by the young Toowoomba Tigers. Hits a target inside forward 50. That's Jasmine Hollands. One of the young Tiger Cubs coming through. Fraser's got an option out to the left, but she's going to ignore that. It's going to go long towards the hotspot. Smart thing to do. It's going to bounce now. Chaos ball. What you like inside 50. Newman's able to get a clearing kick out, though. Ever reliable Danielle Newman. But it's going to come back in from the other way. Baker's going to send it in from the Tigers. Up over the top. Few Bombers to contend with. And it's out in the full. It's a little bit wayward.
Back into play here. We just don't know where the runners are at the moment for South Toowoomba. The likely candidates are Pogany and Crothers. Well, Crothers is actually the one who ends up with the football here deep in the back half. So I'd say that South Toowoomba want her to have the footy a lot further up the ground. But she pumps it up, just puts it out sort of back 50. But the Tigers pick it up and just send it straight back to where it's come from. And Crothers works hard. A great contested effort there by Crothers to not allow that mark to go ahead. But again, they just kick it out into space and it's going to be wrapped up by the Tigers here as the
South girls try to swarm in to pick up that footy, but again, it just repelled straight in and finds a target in Jericho. Great mark there, and she's going to line up about maybe just on the edge of her range there, probably about 35 metres out as she elects to play on and find a better target. And, well, stand more there, the young jet, form South number clean footy up.
Right idea by Jericho to send it in, but Bombers have got a few answers in the back six at the moment. Ground level, going out the footy there was Watson. Just spilling out, Baker now. It's going to wheel onto that right boot, pump it as long as possible. Mark Tigers! Good grab there by Mia Jordan. Just positioned her body well, and it was able to be a nice easy chest mark straight forward for the young Toowoomba Tiger. On a tight angle, not the longest of set shot routines, but it'll do, and it's the first major of the afternoon for the Toowoomba Tigers.
And as the Tigers roll their rounds, roars even over the crowd, it's probably a reward of preference for Tigers. They've really had all the answers at the moment in this first term. And just as we head towards the 5 minutes to go, Mark, I think it's a bit of a reward of preference for Tigers. And potentially Coach Jericho probably want a couple more on the scoreboard, I think. But 1-1-7 plays 0-0-0. Tigers way on this great Sir Doug Nicholls round, and don't their Tigers ladies jerseys look sensational?
Yeah, great design by Dakota Davidson, I believe. No, I got that wrong. She just presented them.
Yeah, Dakota was up throughout the week. Obviously, the Lions W Premiership star, which is a huge coup for the club. As Watson there, unfortunately, well, actually gets the free kick. It was a great tap
against
by
Walters.
Her.
Just against Walters, yeah. Just blocking.
Yeah, free kick goes Watson's way. She sends the ball out, looking for a target. Contested, spoiled there by Sanchez, does well. As Tigers just bust through the pack again there by, not sure who that was there, but the footy goes forward, Travis Spills and Marshall probably should have taken in the half back line and turns up her own footy, and clearly Wall finds Herdon just inside the centre square. She plays on a bit riskily against the young Fraser, and the ball still forward. McKeever going to get the footy there. Chaos ball spilling down everywhere. Watson goes in and clears that footy, sends it forward, and straight back to the name. We've pulled a fair bit today already in Crothers. You see, bit of a nothing hand pass, cleaned up by Fraser as the ball spills out just at the top of the 50. Dangerous spot here for the South Toowoomba girls, who certainly don't want to give anything to the Tigers girls, but it looks like the umpires have just picked up a little push in the back there, and as Tigers look to go straight back into their full 50.
So Fraser with the footy, just weighing up her options, going to go out to the right half forward flank because Jericho's presented well, but not able to quite get there. Maybe it's that Rockville doctor that's blowing through at the moment. Nice little sneaky breeze. Or Newman just goes back on the inside. Very, very dangerous. Sanchez, Gray's able to run her down and just impact that kick as she disposed of it. Nice body work there. Both players going in at the football. And the umpire's just going to circle, and it might just pop out there, but it's wrapped up enough for a stoppage. All right, half forward flank, about 60 metres out from the Tigers' goals.
As the clock ticks down, 3 minutes to go here, I'd say South Melbourne are probably going to want to get on the scoreboard if anything, just for their confidence at the moment. But Tigers again with a clearance through Watson, pumping the ball forward with South Melbourne's Crothers there. Just trying to do all the work. She's going to have some sore shoulder in this quarter, I think. She's repelled a fair bit of the Tigers' entry as Newman lays a great tackle. Defensive pressure has been excellent with a great hip and shoulder there that releases Anguri with a footy, but the ball really goes nowhere as it bounces around like a bit of a pinball in that forward pocket. And it may just pop out here for the Tigers, but the ball still can't quite find a clean possession as it pinballs around. Grundon goes in to pick up the footy. The ball spills out the back to Tigers again. And here is the footy, kicks it forward. Dangerous spot, but it's all South Toowoomba back there as the ball rolls out of bounds, and we'll have a boundary throw in. It's a pretty dangerous spot for Tigers.
Yeah, 2 minutes and a bit of change left in this first quarter. We're enjoying the coverage on Tiger TV. Sir Doug Nicholls round right across the country. As Rucks go at it, Jericho's at able to hit that one out. Pogany's at the fall of the footy. Angu couldn't quite just take it for the Tigers. So we've got a repeat stoppage. About 10 metres out from the Tigers' goal. Just need a clean possession, but good luck with that because there's players everywhere. It's like seagulls to a chip. Running straight through the footy at the moment. Stanmore's got it. Pogany was trying her best, but now it's going to be Fraser and Pogany. Two balls going at it. Fraser just picks up. Oh, nearly had it cleanly. Hauls back on the inside. Here's Herdon. Herdon can't quite take it. Fumbled a little bit. Fraser's working hard inside 50, and the umpire's going to say below knee contact. So Fraser free now. Few options, just going to wheel and go. The new player standing on the mark rule to the advantage of the attacking teams. He's going to roll through. Will that do? Yes, sir. No, it won't. It's touched.
Just touched. Suspense is killing you, the young boundary umpire down there in Anderson. Doing a great job in his first year of umpiring as well. So Newman's got the footy, puts the hand up, which I reckon is going to signal a long bomb out to that far wing at the moment. The percentage play, and she takes a bounce and plays on. So Newman now runs to about 25, pumps it well outside that back 50, and it's just all Tigers again though at the moment. Looks like Hunt there may have just kicked that ball out of bounds, but it rolls over and will have a boundary throw in just forward of the Tigers forward flank with just under a minute to go on the Coomber Tigers spotted power scoreboard.
Nice little throw out to the sponsors there, Mitchell, as Tigers hit that one out, win that hit out through Watson. Now Baker sends it inside, forward 50. Just bobbling around up there. Angu's going to apply a lot of pressure on the South Toowoomba Bombers. Newman's caught, nice tackle, Angu, she'll be rewarded. And this might be a handy little goal. Looking at some of the games beforehand, it seems that this might be the scoring end, but Angu just says, you know what, let's just get on with it. Puts it across the face, and it's a minor.
Probably had a little bit more time there. The scoreboard read 30 seconds and probably just had a chance to settle and probably put a second nail in the coffin. Again, Tigers 1-3-9 leading South Toowoomba yet to score with about 15 seconds left. You think unless South Toowoomba make a critical error here, you think that's how the first quarter will end up as Crothers plays on out of the square and again look to come the commentary box side here, which is one of the first times the Bulls really spent any time out here. The interception by Watson, and you know, unless Watson's going to have a barrel from 60,
which, give it a crack. Give it a crack, I say.
May just be a little bit of weight from the young 17-year-old. In her first year of senior football this year, Watson's been super impressive as a senior footballer. But,
never say never, Mitchell.
I think this would be beyond even some of the best of footballers, Jeff.
Give it a crack.
Fair roost, but just a little bit offline there.
Didn't mind it.
That's all she wrote for the first quarter here. Toowoomba Tigers hosting South Toowoomba AFL Senior Women's Competition 1-3-9 leading South Toowoomba 0-0-0.
It is quarter time. We'll be back after this short break for the second quarter action.
The former Tigers Indigenous polo that's been produced in association with the Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, from wherever you may be streaming. You are here on Toowoomba AFC YouTube, live from Rockfield Park, round seven, Sir Doug Nicholls round action between the two heavyweights of the competition this year, the undefeated Tigers against the undefeated South Toowoomba Bombers. As the siren to start the second quarter gets underway, I'm joined by former Premiership player and Quaffle W star at the moment, Tiana Jericho. How are you, T? That's good. The ball gets underway. Fraser again, just in and under, doing what she does best in it, winning some contested football, and she gets wrapped up, and the umpires will call the ball up straight away, not far from where they bounced it to start with.
Looks like we've got an injury there. Could that be Fraser? Yeah. Hopefully that's not too serious there.
No, she's pretty tough on standing not far away from her father at the moment, and she's not too fazed. So the ball's thrown up by the umpire. Play on's called as the ball's bouncing around. Fregonese tries to get the hand pass out there. Bit of a scrappy ball. Baker gets the ball, pumps it forward in a great forward entry. And, well, just spilt there by the Tigers half forward as Hunt picks the footy up. Evades a couple. Just razzle dazzle. Crothers tries to make the tackle. Slips away. She runs in a goal here at the moment. The ball's just straight through the legs of Whitley as the ball is just on the boundary line. Goal line. Scrappy footy. There was a kick there given. And that is a goal, T. It looked like it was Jordan. I think she's just managed to get a little bit of a feather of a toe on that.
Rip a goal just what they needed at the start of this quarter.
That's right. Great start by the Tigers, stamping their authority straight on this second term as Fraser comes to the bench with a bit of a sore body there. But I'm sure she'll get treated and back into the ground at no time. So 2-3-15 reads 0-0-0 on the Spotted Cow scoreboard here. And as we see the ball brought back, I just think at the moment the Tigers have got all the answers that South Toowoomba are asking them.
Yeah, definitely. We're looking at some of those South Toowoomba stars to sort of step up here, I think, if they're wanting to stay in this game at the moment. Tigers look like they're just on top at the moment, but anything can happen in the second quarter.
So the ball goes up. Pryor gets over the top, but Watson actually gets a big fist on the ball, straight down to Fregonese, South Toowoomba. Pogany's charging hard at the footy there. Great tackling pressure by South. They obviously want to win this footy back and get a clearance early. A little push in the back there. Let's play on, says the umpires, as the ball spills out of the far wing. Young Collins with the footy now just sends a roosting football up to the far side of Rockfield Park here as the ball's cleaned up again by the Tigers girls. They're just absolutely unstoppable at the moment in that half back line. Impenetrable, but a great tackle there. Watson just took on one too many and has been pinged by, looks like Pryor there, I think, laid the tackle. Can't quite see that far side here from the commentary box, but either way, it's a South Toowoomba jersey who's got the free kick, and the ball sent in for a rare forward 50 entry at the moment as the ball just goes over head of the pack, rolls down towards the forward line. Penny Duke's a bit of great bodywork there to force out her opponent as it's cleaned up by the Tigers girls, and all the numbers there are yellow and black as they just rebound that ball. But Fregonese, one of the star midfielders of the competition, takes that mark and probably out of her range. We'll look for a target here. There's a few options. Sanchez is short. That's where she looks to go, but just over her head. Spoiled there by the Tigers as the ball bounces around. A few different coloured hands on the footy there. Red jerseys, yellow jerseys everywhere as the ball's pinballing around and no one really wanting to take ownership of that footy as the ball spills out. Clout with the footy now. The recruit this year, the number 23, puts it on the boot and, oh, just a little bit short. Taken in the goal square there by the Tigers. Jessica, was that Moon back there, T? I think it was.
I think that was Courtney Lang, actually.
Courtney Lang. Plenty of new faces in this six-time premiership winning side, the Toowoomba Tigers, as the balls kick forward just a minor score. And look, it's been a game today that everyone's been, I guess, licking their lips for in the women's competition to see who would come out on top. The obviously six-time premiership coach at the Tigers, Neville Jericho, who you'd probably know quite well, T.
Yeah, looking forward to this game pretty much all season, to be honest.
And I know changing throughout the week, he was very excited. The young Alex Kratzman for South Toowoomba in his first senior coaching role this season has done a wonderful job with the South girls as well. As the ball's thrown back up there and play continues, down in the forward pocket for South Toowoomba. Looks like McKeever with the footy there. She knows how to find a way to goal, but smothered. Well done. Plenty of defensive pressure from the Tigers at the moment as Jericho throws on the left boot and that just misses an absolute air swing. So the ball's gone forward, not 15, the umpire says. Play on. Ball's kicked back forward again, but look, as we keep saying, intercept marks. I doubt we're keeping stats at the moment, but the Tigers girls are absolutely killing that space at the minute.
Yeah, definitely. We've got Chrissy coming down for a for a bit of a run. Will she get caught? No, she escapes. Running too far there. It's caught by the umpire though.
Yeah, she's an exciting player in her first season, Watson. She just a bit off a little bit more than she could chew there, but certainly love to see her taking the game on and lighting up the crowd here at Rockfield Park. So the ball sent forward again. Scrappy footy. Freganese picks up the ball, hands it off to Herden, who tries to bust a tackle, gets a kick on the ball forward as Lamb tries to pick up the footy, keep it in play, but it looks like the ball may be play on call. Doesn't cross the ball yet. Everyone stopped. But I think the umpires now have realised, yes, the ball, it did in fact cross that line for a minor score. And 2-3-15, read 0-2-2. South's trying to claw back this 13-point lead in just in singles at the moment. So they'll definitely be looking to capitalise on this bit of breeze that's heading to the north end of Rockfield Park, T. Not a lot of action happening there as the ball's just wrapped up just outside the forward, or just inside the forward 50, I should say, full South Toowoomba. It's dangerous part of the ground now for the Tigers, but they've repelled everything that Souths have thrown at them so far. Pogany goes in to try and win that footy. A few bodies going everywhere. The umpire's picked up a little free kick there, a little bit overzealous, Watson, on that tackle, just without the footy. So the ball goes McKeever's way as she takes she's a booming kick, but with a mark set there about 47 metres out. I think this may just be a little bit beyond it. There's not a lot of movement here from South Toowoomba as McKeever just weighs up her options. Given the full 30 seconds as she sends it forward, and well, it's a deep kick, goes into the forward pocket, but it just rolls out of bounds and there'll be a ball up in the forward pocket on the far side of Rockfield Park here. So ball up deep in the South Toowoomba forward line. Lang gets a hit out. Finds her teammate. Great bit of ruck roving work there as the ball sends forward. Jericho drops one she probably should have marked. Lauren won't mind me saying that about it. As Souths pick up the sloppy football on the ground and send it forward to Lamb. I think that was another one of the other South Toowoomba Jets from the that was unearthed in the under-17s competition earlier this year. And Chrissy Watson again with the footy. She's taking plenty of work back there as she goes in for a second effort and the ball keeps spilling forward, spilling out again. Baker goes in to pick up that footy. It's finally a little bit of a clearance there. Boot to ball, goes only as far as the centre of the ground with Tigers. Almost, they've had one out there. There was a 3-on-1 and Souths win it rightly so as Crothers tries to clean up the football. And after a great first quarter of football, Crothers will hope to get a lot more football up the ground, I'd say. But it looks like Coach Kratzman's got her off the halfback flank at the moment. So Jericho sends that ball forward, dropped by Hunt, and there's Crothers, the name we keep calling again. Pryor with the footy, sends it up to Collins. Hand passes out the back now. Plenty of runners here for South Toowoomba, but they just make a bit of a mess of that one. As the Tigers girls, again, their tackling pressure is really showing dividends at the moment, as South Toowoomba just look a little bit unsure under the football. As Crothers again, I'm going to hear that name a lot today, I think, as she sends that ball forward deep, but only as far as the Tigers players again, as the ball is smothered and rolls out of bounds for a ball up. Watson winning another tap there, down to her Tigers teammate. Clearance is there for the Tigers as the ball runs forward. Kicks the ball past halfway, centre wing. Just a bit scrappy again, but looks like South Toowoomba may pick that up. Strong tackle. But the ball just dribbles over the far boundary line, almost right on the centre wing of the field. The ball will be balled up by umpire Miles here. We will pay homage to the two men in green today, young Rowan Miles and Basil Thomas, new to the region umpiring their first season of footy in the Darling Downs this year. As the ball's kicked forward, Tigers have a loose play here. A couple of loose ones there. It looks like Hunt with the footy now in an absolute paddock. Pogany's chasing it down hard though. Will she get there? No. Sends the ball forward. Over the back, the ball. Unlucky bounce if you're a Tiger supporter, but it looks like South Toowoomba will mop up there through Whiteley. Just repels that footy as Walters, I think, will pick up the footy, but under pressure. Doesn't go 15. That ball will be play on. Jericho sits under the football. Bit of a sitting duck, but will be wrapped up by some good tackling pressure there by Souths. And well, against the flow of the game, Tigers have had all the answers, but haven't had a lot of footy in their forward 50 at the moment, and probably missed an opportunity there. So where does the answer going to come from, T, at the moment? I think Tigers have certainly had all the answers. Who needs to stand up for South Toowoomba, do you think?
know, that she's there all like, you know, really doing all the work, basically, South Toowoomba, if I say so myself. I think it probably just comes from some of their supporting players. I think they, some of them might just need to step up a little bit and give them a bit more support there. Because as everyone knows, you can't have a couple players doing all the work for your team. You've got to really spread that one out there.
Yeah, I think that's been the key to the success of the Toowoomba Tigers so far today, is there's been plenty of users of the footy as they win the ball forward again. Crothers, that name we keep calling, with another rebound off half-back flank. She sends the ball back into the South Toowoomba half as Sanchez finds a little bit of space here on her opponent. Bit of a race to the football. Close to the wing here. There's a 2-on-1 here now as Sanchez and Friganese run together. Unfortunately, the ball just comes off the instep there, and the ball rolls out of bounds, and probably a bit of a wasted opportunity there. Had young Lamb in plenty of space in the forward line for South Toowoomba, but not to be. The ball's out of bounds, and it will be balled up, and look, dangerous territory for South Toowoomba here as we tick under, just about to tick under 4 minutes left in the second term, and I'd say with that breeze, South will probably want to get at least one goal on the scoreboard, just if anything, to boost their confidence heading into the main break. But the ball goes up, and Sanchez and Angui fight for the footy. Stanmore, the young star for the South Toowoomba, kicks the ball. Lucky bounce. The ball just keeps bouncing and bouncing and bouncing. It's almost done a U-turn there as the ball deep in the right against that line, though. We can't quite see. There's players everywhere. There's a little kick on the football, but it looks like just the one finger goes up from the goal umpire, and that is a behind. And again, just the Bombers doing it in singles at the moment, and it's not quite enough. They really need to kick a goal here to even this contest back out. As Lang just plays on, pumps the ball deep, might just sit inside their forward 50, their back 50, sorry. And I'm not sure who's got the footy there. Number 4 says it's Passfield, but it looks like it's Chloe Mills. As the ball's played on, good pressure on the mark there by Stanmore. She goes in to win that footy back. Sanchez picks the ball up. Scrappy ball, plenty of hands on it at the moment. It's a good tackle there, looks like. Sanchez laying a good tackle, a little bit of fire there, a little bit of pressure, a little bit of frustration showing from the Tigers girls there, but certainly in control of this match at the moment. So the ball goes up, Pryor wins a tap, straight down to an opposition player as she wins her, goes and rows her own ruck work, kicks the ball away, and it's a dangerous spot, Lamb there, you don't want to give her too much space, very dangerous left foot as she looks to swing around onto that left foot here, and she's kicked it straight through the middle of the behind post. Unfortunately, again, Lamb looking very dangerous down there, but just another minor score to the South Toowoomba Bombers as they still trail by 11, 2, 3, 15, plays 0, 4, 4 on the Spotted Cow scoreboard. Thanks to Toowoomba AFC again for their live streaming coverage today of Sir Doug Nicholls' round. Round 7 action of the AFL DDW season as Crothers now finds her way a little bit further up the field. As where's Pogany? There's a couple of two of the best midfielders in the competition linking in together there, but they both just go without it. Look at each other as the ball spills to Tigers, and there's black and yellow jerseys everywhere. A little throw there gets out, missed by the umpire. There's a bit of luck that South Toowoomba might need as Stanmore sends it forward, and Lang in trust will mop up that footy again there, but young Lamb is wearing her like a glove at the moment as South Toowoomba try and turn this ball over. Clouch with the footy now. The Wagga Wagga recruit sends the ball forward to a dangerous spot, but that ball just rolls out, and probably a good result in the end. Tigers will be looking to clear this ball out and hold on just with about 90 seconds remaining in the first half. And Emerald South have got just 90 seconds to, well, kick their first of the game. So really important 90 seconds here for the game as the ball's thrown up. Goes to Friganese. She cleans the ball up. Clout back with the footy now, deep in that pocket. Has a snap at goal. She may well have kicked it, but it's just, again, unlucky bounce. But Pryor, the captain, now tries to wrap up. And I believe that's actually Sanchez. Throws onto the left boot as he goes over the top. Another unlucky bounce as it's bouncing around in the goal square. Jukes there. Penny, that is, just kicks the ball out as Tigers, again, have all the answers and mop up the footy. And just a little bit of a spill there, and the ball heads out of bounds. So just under a minute to go. Ball up here in the reverse pocket now, and well, we've got a beautiful look to goal here, Tiana, as the clock winds down. Who do you reckon is looking dangerous around this contest?
The Souths are looking pretty good, although the Tigers' defence just doesn't look like they can get it past them. They seem to have the answers for everything at the moment. Lane's doing pretty well commanding that back line down there, making sure all the players are sort of marked up. Might have a spill over the line there.
So it's a bit of a rugby scrum there. Penny Jukes, rugby sevens convert, is doing all the heavy lifting down in that back line, and The multi-premiership winner, Jukes, has just seen that ball over the boundary line. The experience has done her well there. Is the ball up with just 10 seconds to go. Dangerous spot, South really need to find something here as Ngui knocks the ball forward. Stanmore lurking, Crothers lurking as well. Last-ditch effort for South to score. Has she done it right on the siren? Oh, just a behind. Just a behind, unfortunately, for the South Toowoomba faithful. And plenty of football down that half, but halftime hooter has sounded, and it's 2-3-15. It leads 0-5-5. Tigers.
Time break, folks. Do make sure.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Sir Doug Nicholls Round 7 AFL DDW clash here between the two top sides in South Toowoomba and the Toowoomba Tigers. Toowoomba Tigers 2-3-15, lead South Toowoomba 0-5-5 as Basil Thomas throws the ball up there. Chrissy Watson again, really strong in the ruck today. Few changes made by Coach Kratzman by looks in the midfield early days. Really star-studded midfield there with Crothers, Freganese, McKeever, all in the centre for the South Toowoomba side as they need to get something going here if they're a chance to stop the juggernaut in the Toowoomba Tigers as they send it forward for the first forward 50 entry of the afternoon as young Fraser cleans up the footy. Only as far as Whitley though for South Toowoomba, sends the ball out. Collins looking for the footy, bit scrappy, ball out here, Baker with the footy out just onside the forward flank for the Tigers. The ball gets sent forward and Newman, the impenetrable force back there for South Toowoomba, cleaning up the footy as Fraser goes back to clean up the ball, finds a loose player and looks like Hunt there for the Tigers, just to the left of the post, and first score of the second half, just a minor. Tigers 2-4-16 now extend their lead out to 11 points. So a big huddle forms here at the top of the forward 50. The fullback Newman puts her hand up in the air. Bit of a code signal there to her teammates as she plays on out of the goal square. Looks to send it long. Does so. The ball there just spills out the back of the pack. Looks like McKeever's going to win the footy. Stanmore's there as well for South Toowoomba. She takes them on. Big fan. Drops the footy. Could be holding the ball there. Tried to take them on, but no prior. Gets the benefit of the doubt from the umpire. And we'll have a ball up right in front of the South Toowoomba coaching box. Jericho not doing much of the ruck work normally there. Taps it down, but the ball, little free kick picked up now there. Looks like holding the player. Looks like Holland's with the football. She'll look to send it in for the second forward 50 entry of the afternoon for the Tigers girls. As she does, looks to find a loose player in Baker. Just standing there all alone. Goes very wide though. It's a tough angle to get back to the goals from there. As she just sends the ball to the percentage spot. Just falls short of the goal square. Punched over the boundary line. And we'll have a ball up in a very dangerous spot for the Tigers. And Tiana Jericho is back in the box joining me now after her little lunch break. So, T, dangerous spot here for the Tigers girls as Crothers again mopping up that ball in the defensive pressure. And the ball spills out. McKeever chasing the footy hard. Plenty of South Toowoomba numbers there. Toll's loose over the back. McKeever ignores her, decides to take the player on, kicks it straight into her. And unfortunately for McKeever, she's turned the footy over. Goes back to win it herself. Goes in for a third time. Looks like Spork there laying a tackle. Great pressure from the debut player. Well, debut season, I should say. Freganese goes in, wins the footy, says, that's mine, I'm going to take it. But the umpires have picked up a little free kick there. Just a little ankle tap. As the Bombers have a chance to settle for the first time this quarter. They've been absolutely under fire. And, well, that Tigers pressure showing again as they turn the football straight over centre wing on the Rockville Park, Tall Street side of the oval. No, they're all quite stagnant, but a few loose players out there now. Great shepherd by Hunt to give her teammate plenty of space as she sends the ball in to Jericho. Lauren, that is there, taking the ball about 25 metres out. Must be almost directly in front. And T, I imagine over the years you've kicked a few balls with Lauren in your day. How do you rate her chances from here? Well, she has absolutely missed everything. So we'll put that down as one of her bad 50s there, T, as the free kick will go South Toowoomba's way, deep in their back pocket. Looks like Crothers is going to go get the footy for her 400th touch today. That right shoulder strapped up, carrying plenty of weight in that back line at the moment. She plays on. Plenty of running footy. That's what South Toowoomba needs. Generate a bit of drive out of the back line. Makes it as far as the 50. Freganese picks it up. Great, strong tackle there by Jericho. She absolutely ragdolled her. The ball spills out, though. Tigers ball. Meskin kicks the ball forward. Ball rolling now, bouncing around. Crothers again. Probably caught one a little high there. Head taken off, and that's the only way to stop her at the moment is to take her head off. As she plays on straight away. Gets the ball going, says, let's go, South Toowoomba. I'm taking this on. So Ball's out, far wing now. Pogarty putting plenty of pressure on the Tigers players. A few South Toowoomba girls there, if they get a chance to mop this ball up through Toll, they might be away, but Watson just takes plenty on, and she may well be done holding the ball. Little cheeky hand pass away there, just gets away with it as the kick finds Jericho for her. Well, she's running hot at the moment, Jericho. She sends the ball forward into the forward 54, the Tigers, as the ball just goes past Fraser there. Two on one, a little two on two now. Plenty of support from the Tigers driving in. Grundon looking for the footy. Fraser again, just leaving a trail of plays in her wake as she picks up the footy, and the ball is going to be wrapped up, ball up on the forward 50 line for the Toowoomba Tigers. So just an injured player down at the moment. Looks like it could be... not sure who that is from there. Looks like it could be Charlotte Collins, the young star, young and up-and-coming star for the Bombers girls. Play's just held up a little bit at the moment. Probably gives South Toowoomba a chance to have a bit of a breather. They've been absolutely under the pump at the moment this quarter. I'd say a 2-3 goal breeze at the moment. It looks like Tigers 2-4-16-0-5-5 haven't really capitalised just yet on this breeze, but plenty of footy being played in their forward half tee. So it looks like they're going to take her straight off the ground. She'll take no further part in today's play. Big loss for the South girls. She had been playing well, but Moody's sitting here at the interchange bench ready to take her spot. So Moody Anthea heads out now to replace the injured player as play gets back underway. Umpire Miles throws the ball up. Whilst is there, gets the tap down. Scrappy footy, no one really taking ownership just yet. Ball goes out, Fraser goes charging through but went without it. Crothers again in and under, earning her packet this afternoon as Fregonese gets the ball out the back. Coda Stanmore with the footy. A little dangerous kick right under the path of Baker, but it looks like Herden's there to clean up as the ball comes out to the opposite side of the ground. Stanmore, little cheeky toe. Ball's running away now. She looks to win that battle against Hollands. Fellow under 17 player. Oh, little cheeky throw there. Missed by the umpires as Watson goes to take on a few players again. And she is pinged for holding the ball. Again, it's that enthusiasm we love from Watson. But she's just, again, bit off a little bit more than she can chew. And great tackle by Coda Stanmore as well. As she sends the ball forward. Pogarty now. Great lead. Great strong second effort there. She takes them on as she does. She loves to run and bounce. Centre wing sends the ball into the forward 50. Sanchez on the lead there. A little bit of a drifting ball. And may have just caught enough of the line there to say that is a ball up. Rather than out on the full. And, well, South's probably bombed a bit of an opportunity there as they were on the run. So Pryor and Watson to go head-to-head here in the ruck. Watson, again, will probably call it. Chalk that one up to her. Ball's won out by the Tigers. Clearance there. Comes to centre wing right in front of the commentary box as the ball rolls out over bounds, beats all the players, and we'll have another ball up right in front of the commentary box. It's probably the first on the ball. Spent a lot of time here right in front of this team, and we get a good chance to look at how they're setting up here. Ball's just bouncing around. Nothing there. Jericho sends the ball forward. Grundon fighting there. She may just get over the back. Newman there cleaning up. The wall for South Toowoomba back there, but the ball's turned over. Young Fraser, she's obviously shook and whatever knocked her up in the second quarter, but now running along. The ball's still spilling forward. Dangerous opportunity here. Crothers back there for South Toowoomba. Just trips over herself. Dangerous, tried to soccer the ball. And the Tigers are in a very dangerous spot as they send it forward. The ball just a bit of a horrible bounce there if you're a Tigers fan, as the ball bounces. Well, really narrow at the moment, stuck between the feet of a few players, as that's going to be balled up right in the middle of the goal square. And T, the ball's just, there must be a magnet now that end of the Tigers field, I think, at the moment. So Hunt now with the footy, one of the leading goal kickers for the Tigers. And rightly so, knows how to find a goal, and she kicks an all-important goal for the Toowoomba Tigers as they really start to stamp their authority on this match now. As the mighty Tiger roar sounds out across Rockville Park. The Toowoomba Tigers now have a handy lead out to three goals, six. 24 over, well, no goals kicked by South Toowoomba at the moment. 0-5-5. So a handy, sorry, 3-4, 22 play 0-5-5. Yeah, the Bombers have had plenty of scoring opportunities. Well, sorry, have found their way plenty of times to goal this year, but yet to hit the scoring board for a major just yet. As Pogany, one of the competition's leading goal kickers, as we talk about that, just turns the footy over, looking for Grundon with the balls spilled out. Baker's over the back now, throws onto the left foot, dangerous spot, and Gooey's down there, but the ball just rolls straight past her for a minor, and 3-5 now, 23. So the margin is a neat 3 goals. And with just 3.5 minutes left in the third term, you'd probably think that Tigers aren't quite comfortable yet with the lead they've got. This powerhouse South Toowoomba side have got plenty of avenues to goal, and I think that Tigers will no doubt in these last couple of minutes want to at least put another one, if not two, onto the scoreboard to really cement their lead in this game. But Newman again just holds that footy up, sending coded messages to the big pack forming just in front of the forward 50 line. As she plays on, sends the ball out to the far side. Moody spills the footy. Bit of a contest there. Tigers look to pick it up. Far wing, can't be far from the boundary line there. Throws onto the boot, not 15. Freganese picks it up, plays on straight away. Kicks the footy, centre wing now goes straight through the legs. McKeever picks the ball up, plays on, takes it on. And well, look at this, bringing her step. She says, come with me, we're going to go forward. Sanchez now spills the mark, but is in plenty of space. Plenty of pace as well. She gives a little hand pass off Crothers there in the forward line. That's a bit of a tactical move from Coach Kratzman, moving one of the best midfielders and halfback flankers in the game to the forward line as McKeever keeps the ball rolling for the Souths. She goes back in to win her footy again. Watson tries to pick up the ball. Little soccer, but picks it up herself. She sends it right back to centre wing as the mark is taken there by, looks like Bree Toll there, far wing four. No, Clout, in fact. As Emily Clout, the new Wagga recruit. She kicks the ball, not really to anyone. The ball rolls through the centre of the ground. Stanmore goes to pick it up at Baker for the Tigers now with the footy. Sends it forward, dangerous spot. Fraser, Hurdon run at the footy. Hurdon, a really strong tackle, but maybe just a little bit overzealous, and the umpire has called that an over-the-shoulder free kick for young Lauren Fraser. And T, she's probably just within her distance here. Plays on quickly to Hunt. And Hunt... There we go. We gave your sister 50-50 before. Less odds for Hunt here as she kicks the ball forward, rolls over the boundary line, and young Will Anderson in the goals there just sticks out the one finger and says that's a behind. 3-6-24, I should say. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Late in the dying stages here of the third term. Hurdon brings the footy back out, sends it long. All Tigers here at the moment. Oh, big. Pogany does what she does best in taking the game on, but just caught there. Watson says, I've given away a couple of free kicks for holding the ball today. I'm going to get one back for the Tigers here, and absolutely ripping tackle there. She plays on, sends the ball forward. Dying stages of the third term here. Ball goes up. Hunt nearly takes a screamer, but Hurdon there. Well, just got a little toe to it. Will it be out of bounds on the full? A little bit of confusion there. Umpires are just... No, they have called it out on the full. So Mel Baker here with a chance to kick a goal late in this third term. There's probably just enough time if she looks to find an opponent. As she does. Does the percentage thing. Sends it to the top of the goal square, but just drifts and ends up for a minor score. And that would just be about all the third quarter will bring us today as the seconds count down. South Toowoomba's Tiffany Hurdon is in absolutely no hurry to pick that footy up as the South girls will want to have a breather and reset for a big final quarter here. Toowoomba Tigers 3-7-25 lead. The goalless Bombers 0-5-5 as we are set up for a massive final quarter of AFL DDW football here at Rockville Park for round 7 Sir Doug Nicholls action. Out. So we are back here live at Rockville Park, thanks to the Toowoomba AFC YouTube channel. A credit to the club and all the work they do to get DD Footy up into the cloud and into your device or TV screen, wherever you may be streaming from around the world. As we get underway in the final term here of the AFL DDW, top of the table clash between South Toowoomba and the Toowoomba Tigers. So the ball up now as Watson goes whack with a fist, but a bit of an air swing as the ball spills out to the centre wing. And Crothers again, absolutely killing it today. She's had a huge amount of possessions and plenty of weight resting on her shoulders in this final term if South Toowoomba are to kickstart their chance to take home the 4 points this afternoon. Pry there with the footy, getting an all-important hand pass out. Clearing ball, Spork now with the ball, just spills it. She runs through, pretty uncontested at the moment, sends the ball out. Centre wing, Pogany, the Heather Green medalist from 2020, and Stanmore, one of the young and up-and-coming players of the competition with Hollands. Well, she's done well there. She's absolutely pickpocketed her, but the ball's pinned straight back by Stanmore, right in front of the centre wing here, as Pogany goes and cleans up her own hand pass. Maybe holding the ball there. She might have just got a foot to it. Luckily, the ball's allowed to play on by the umpires. Collins gets the ball out and snaps it onto her foot. Now Clout here with the footy. She's got a chance to kick the South Toowoomba's first of the afternoon, but just shanks it. Absolutely kicks the belly out of that footy, turns it over, and disappointing result for the red and black there. Clout, one of the big pickups for South Toowoomba this year, moving to the region from the mighty Riverina in Wagga Wagga, and probably would have hoped we've done a bit better with that kick there. So quick kick out now, Clout to potentially, no, she hasn't. I thought she may have cleaned up her work after I just put the mocker on her, but she's kicked another behind. And again, South Toowoomba just doing it in singles. 3-goal the margin now.
By the looks of it at the moment, I reckon South Toowoomba actually think they've got a bit more pressure on them than they actually do. I think the Tigers' pressure all day has just been so hard that, they're just feeling more pressure than it's actually there, because they definitely had a little bit extra time that they could have straightened up.
Yeah.
Had that shot there.
Certainly that perceived pressure from the experienced Tigers outfitters. The young Stanmore goes pretty hard there against her counterpart in the Tigers. Pogany diving for that footy now, right at the top of the goal square. Clout with the ball, spills out. Pryor, one of the South's leading goal kickers. She gets a little push in the back. Let go. No, it has been picked up. Great call by the umpires there, as South Toowoomba will get the free kick. Just to be able to see who's got the footy there. It might be Pryor, but in fact... Anyway, it's a red jumper at South Toowoomba's ball, and they get a chance to kick their first goal of the afternoon, and it looks like they have. Great kick there by, looks like, Osmak down there. She kickstarts the South Toowoomba's run and cuts the margin just back to 2 goals. Yeah, so we'll just see how they set up here. Coach Kratzman's certainly going to have to make a few changes. So we've got Pryor in the ruck, Crothers, Collins and Sanchez. So plenty of hardball gets and plenty of speed in that midfield as the ball goes down the far side. Moody goes hard at the footy. She wins it back. Little chip forward, may not be 15. Ball plays on anyways, it spills out. Collins picks up the ball just at the north end of the goal square. She's tackled in a great wrap-up by the Tigers. Looks like Meskin there with a great tackle as she wins a free kick for her side. And again, that great defensive pressure keeping South Toowoomba on their toes. So she finds Watson right in the middle of the ground as the mark set right on our halfway line. So the ball's kicked now by Watson. Far side, the young Fraser, she's been great today. Plays on quickly, looking for opportunities. So the ball up forward, Hunt under the football, one of the leading goals kickers for the Tigers side. Now, ball spilling around, bouncing around, no one really finding it. Collins kicks the ball out, pinballing around. Plenty of yellow and black jumpers there. But it looks like Osmak runs in hard. Plenty of pressure, and Stairmore spills one she probably could have taken there. And the ball, after all that, plenty of bouncing around. Watson's cleaned up the footy and sends the Tigers forward for the first time this quarter. Whitley puts a little bit of milk on that, but she may have got a fair push in the back, and she's going to win that free kick. So South Toowoomba, a chance to reload here. Two goals of difference. 10 minutes left on the clock. Collins is wrapped up in a strong tackle there by, looks like the young Hollins? No, not Hollins. Not sure who that was. Great tackle nonetheless. So the ball's balled straight up. No mucking around here by the umpires. Tigers fighting around for that footy. Gets it forward, and sitting under that ball is, again, Tiana.
She can make the distance. She passes off. A little intercept there, but Baker still gets under it. Bit of a contest in there. An umpire picks something up. Holding the ball there for against Tigers.
Yeah, Whitley doing a mountain of work back there at the moment. She's a solid defender for the South Toowoomba outfit, and she's a couple of big plays there as she will look to reset the South Toowoomba attack. From deep in the back line, she sends it out, but only as far as a black and yellow jumper again. So McEwen with the footy now, right on the forward 50 line, sends it forward. Sanchez may have just tugged on the jumper there of Hunt, and maybe Hunt, well, might think she's in range this time. She doesn't look too much like she's looking around. There's no one really presenting, and, well, the Tigers' leading goal kicker, I think, is going to go back, take the time, and try and pop this one over. She's going to have to kick from about 35 out. Strikes it well. Rick's going to go right to the line. Touch ball. Squeezed out. Bouncing around, and Gilly with the footy now. Crothers going in hard again, doing a mountain of work back there. And, well, she's still got it, actually. She's allowed to play on. The ball must have transferred hands a couple of times in there. We can't see. Fraser down on the ground doing the hard work. Hunt with the footy, chopped off by Crothers. And a little ragdoll off the ball there. Umpire picks it up. And it's going to be Sanchez, I think, getting the free kick. A little bit pushy there from the South girls. They're obviously fired up. Some stirring words potentially from Coach Kratzman at three-quarter time. And well, two goals still the difference here at Rockfield Park. Just over 7.5 minutes left to play in this final term. And a game that's going to mean a lot for the season. It's the undefeated heavyweights going head-to-head today. And, well, the winner is definitely going to hold bragging rights as we head into the halfway point of the season.
Yeah, most definitely. We won't even get to see these two teams meet until the last round. So it'll definitely have a lot. Basically, this is all.
Well, there you go. You might have to chat to someone about the fixtures there if they're only playing twice. But the ball's now centre wing. Watson just charging that football, trying to look for a free kick. The ball's spilt forward again. A little bit of tunnel ball happening there. Rushed forward. Baker. Spork runs in, lays some pretty good pressure. And South just look like they're mounting the charge at the moment and putting a little bit of pressure back on the South, back on the Tigers girls, I should say, as Herdon dives on that footy, not making any attempt to get rid of it, and rightly so, umpire Thomas blows holding the ball. Fraser wastes no time as she looks to get the Tigers ball rolling, and Newman sits under that football, spilling out the back. Whitley again, she's been solid back there for South Toowoomba this quarter as Toll sends the ball back out of the defensive 50 and a little bit of breathing space for the red and black.
Yeah, it just looks like Tigers might be missing a bit of a forward, key forward down there. Sort of looks like there's not a lot of movement down in that forward line for the Tigers, which can make it a little bit hard for those midfielders trying to send that ball in.
Well, there we go. Tiana wanted the target, and number 20, Mia Jordan, presents and takes a mark. She's found her way to goal a couple of times today, but this may just be a little bit beyond her range. She's probably got a kick from about 35 metres. She's confident. Not a bad looking kick. It's nice and accurate ball. Might have just touched hands there as there's a scrap on the goal line. Little chip kick. That may well have just snuck through from Chloe Hunt. And it is all clear. There's a goal against the run of play. And, well, a couple of the keys for the Tigers joining there to kick their fourth of the afternoon and take that lead back out to a comfortable 18 points.
think that one might have been a crucial goal in this game, actually, Mitch. Going against, well, I guess the goal end. Pretty crucial there for the Tigers. We'll see what the South Toowoomba Bombers do in a... I guess they've got to respond now. I think it'd be pretty crucial if they want to stay in the game, if they get the next goal. But we'll see what happens.
Yeah, I think with the clock now ticking towards just about 5 minutes left to play, time is of the essence for South Toowoomba. Just kicking the one goal for the game. They need to kick at least three if they're to at least draw level here with only 5 minutes to go. Pogany says, let's go try and find that football. But Meskin cleans it up, sends it forward, and Whitley cuts off the ball there as she's done plenty of times this quarter and just goes in a little bit hard and pinballs a few players out of the way. But Pryor, now the captain's got the footy, tries to throw it on the boot, has an air swing, and the ball is scrappy around, just sitting at the top of the Toowoomba Tigers attacking 50 as the umpire picks up a little free kick there going Herdon's way. Usually a good user of the footy. She's a long penetrating kick and she'll need to be here to get South Toowoomba going. So she throws it on the boot, heads up just to centre wing. And Stanmore nearly cops that one on the end of the chin, but the ball still falling in South Toowoomba's favour. It's turned over, however, all Tigers here in the centre of the ground. Some strong tackling pressure. It just looks like South Toowoomba aren't really confident to go and pick up that footy at the moment as Herdon again cramps up a little. Might be a little gamesmanship there, but buys herself a little bit of time as she kicks it out to the far wing. So Moody with the footy now. She's got the ball, little shovel pass out the front. And Pogany, I'd say, will probably try and pick the ball up here and take the play on, but she's dumped in a strong tackle again by Chrissy Watson. She's been an absolute force today and certainly giving away a few free kicks, but I think the ones she's generated have been excellent as Pogany sends the ball forward to Crothers. A couple of names have called a heap today. She's got the footy far flank for the South Toowoomba on the Tall Street side. Looks like McKeever now with the footy. Sends the ball forward. There's an open goal square here at the moment. If Claire can hold on to the footy... She can't, spills it, steals the ball. Stanmore throws on the boot. Where's it going to bounce? Bounce is still into play. The ball's live. Looks like Lang back there gets wrapped up by McKeever. And, well, with just under 3 minutes to go now, I think that was probably the last chance for South Toowoomba to kick a goal. And I think from here you could probably say that it's Toowoomba's afternoon.
Looks like there might be a little bit of confusion where this free kick's going. I think Lang might have actually kicked that one out on the full there. So it looks like a South Toowoomba kick. They might actually have another chance in this game yet.
So Lauren McKeever now, the trusty right foot. She swings around, gives herself a bit of space, but probably just rushes herself on the mark there and kicks another behind. And, well, they say it's a handy point in football this late in the game. Just a straight three goals now. Four South Toowoomba would see them steal probably an unthinkable win, but as Lee Matthews always said, if the clock reads less minutes than there are goals to be kicked, then you're no chance. So a few last-ditch efforts here from South Toowoomba to pin this back. Pogany now trying to will the team forward as she gets wrapped up in a tackle and the ball spills out. Diving in there, look, even to the death here with a three-goal lead, Toowoomba are all over the South Toowoomba girls with their pressure at the moment. So you can see there again another crunching tackle, earning themselves a holding the ball, and that probably sums up the day, T. I think that Tigers have just shown that they're willing to attack the football, hunt in packs, and lay the important tackles has really won them, is good. In a couple of minutes have won them the 4 points today.
Yeah, most definitely, and I think that just comes back to the experience. A lot of these girls have been playing together for quite a long time. I think it's driven into them pretty well on that tackling pressure and everything, so I think that really helps. And at the end of the day, tackling is usually what gets you the win.
That's right, a couple of players down in back play here, one from either side as Crothers gets the footy, passes it on to Collins, she sends it forward, clout out full forward, just gets cut off again by Lang. She's been excellent back there today for the Toowoomba Tigers side as the umpires hold up play here with just over 60 seconds left on the clock. Just a few players down, and that may well be all she wrote today. Decisive game in the 2021 AFL DDW season. The two undefeated sides, only one would leave today remaining undefeated, as it looks like that will go of the six-time reigning premiers, the Toowoomba Tigers. We are obviously a long way away from the end of the season and the crucial part of the 2021 year, but at this stage you could definitely say that the Tigers have got the bragging rights, but look, a real good hit out for both sides, T.
Oh, definitely, and I think you can see
see that both sides really gave them the rule today, and I reckon you'll come back for that next game that they play against each other, and I reckon it'll be probably even closer than this one. Couldn't say that the Tigers win this one again. I'd say it'll just be whichever team turns up.
Yeah, exactly right, and I think the amount of depth and talent across both squads here, and not only experienced heads, but a number of really exciting young players as well. It's going to, you know, anything can happen across the season, but these two have shown why they're the top two sides of the year, and Toowoomba Tigers will reign victors today in the round 7 clash, 4-6-30. They've been all over the Bombers today, 1-7-13, as they wrap up the round 7 Sir Doug Nicholls round game here at Rockville Park. As the Tigerland tune reigns way over the top of the crowd here, it's a happy day if you're a Tigers fan. And Tiana, thanks for joining me on the coverage. Thanks to Jeff Newman earlier today. We'll actually be calling him very shortly as the men are due to get underway in just over 15 minutes at 2:30 p.m. Again, thanks to the Toowoomba Tigers for their efforts on the live stream today. And we will be back with you shortly for the Allied Cup Round 7 senior clash between the Toowoomba Tigers and the South Toowoomba Bombers. Thank you.